Hey guys, this is the second part of our twofer. Our great Sunday dinner is dessert, banana cream pie. Check out the ingredients.
Some banana, whipped topping, whipped cream, Philadelphia cream cheese, whole milk, vanilla wafers, sugar, some sweet condensed milk, some vanilla, instant banana pudding. And you're going to need a bowl for this half. So you're going to take the cream cheese and you're going to whisk it and soften it. Can't find my beater, so I'm using this. You're going to add some condensed milk into it. Just try to get as much as you can, get everything into it. And then you're going to whisk again. You're going to keep whisking. So basically, you're trying to get it real soft so it can get like a creamy consistent, because this is the base of your pudding and your filling. So just keep whisking. It's going to take a while. Now, since you got it creamy enough, you want to take the instant pudding and you want to go ahead and add that in. So you're going to keep whisking. Now you're just blending the pudding flavor into it. And then you're going to add some vanilla, pure vanilla, to me gets the best flavor. And then you want to add your milk. You want to add the milk slowly into it until you get a pudding consistency. So you're about to need about a cup and a half of milk, as the box say. Sometimes smaller, depending on how thick you want the pudding to be. So just keep adding it until you get that consistency. The reason why you're going slow is just so that way it can just smoothen out and you can feel how much milk you want and you won't put too much. So just go ahead and keep whisking. You want it to be real smooth. Just keep adding to the milk. Sometimes it's going to take a while until you get that right consistency. Like right about now, we're almost close. So we're just going to keep whipping it. It's some hard work, so yeah. If you had a beater, it'll be faster. Now I got my little helper. She's cutting the banana. Now, this is you're going to need. So you want to go ahead and cut it. Now, after you cut the bananas and slice them up, I use about 3 of them for this because this is the bottom base. Then you want to go ahead and add some sugar. Now, I was thinking about just sautéing it with some sugar and some wine. That's a great idea. You can do that, or you can just go ahead and just add some sugar to it and just put it into a bowl. So you want to go ahead and cut all 3 and just place it into a bowl and add your sugar. All right, so now we have the pudding mix out of the refrigerator, which got a little bit thicker. And which is what we wanted. You want to go ahead and add the whipped cream into it. Now, this is going to make it nice and smooth. And you're going to love the consistency because this is going to make it smooth and creamy. This is our filling for the banana cream pie. So now you're just whipping. You're not mixing. You want to just spoon it up and whip it. So we have the base done. You can do it yourself or you can buy the crackers. So what my kids basically did is crunched it up. We add a little butter, like a half a teaspoon, tablespoon of butter or a tablespoon. And just, you know, basically like you're doing a pie crust. Now you're going to take the banana that we just had and you're going to spread it evenly on the pan. You want to, like, it's taking me a while just because I want it to be perfect. So I spread it out as evenly as possible so there's really no hole. Okay, once you're done, you're going to grab the filling. And we're going to use the filling and we're going to scoop it in. Go ahead, don't be shy. Just go ahead and scoop that in there. This thing smells so good. It's like banana, fresh bananas. So you want to go ahead and spread it out evenly. Once you got everything out the pan, excuse my hands, I hope you can see it. So you're spreading it out easily. Now you're almost done. You want to go ahead and now we're putting the topping. So I'm basically garnishing it with some vanilla wafers going around. My kids are helping me, so yes, I don't have multiple hands, but it is my kids. They're helping me do this. It's easier with more people, so go ahead and spread it out. Do your own decorations, just make it real pretty. But I usually do this because everyone can get a cookie when we slice it. So you're almost done. Now we got the base in. You want to take the whipped topping, and now we're going to put it on top. I just scoop out big clumps and then I just move it around afterwards. It's just easier so that way you won't constantly be digging into the box and pretty much dirtying the spoon. So just scoop out enough where you feel like it's going to fill the top, okay? So just keep going with that. Now you could do designs with it. You could actually pipe it on there. There's so many things you could do with it. I mean, I've seen people actually take a lighter to it and just cook it and have the, like a crumble top, or you could just do so much with it. You guys I'm just doing the patty method so that way, you know, it's something that we're gonna eat for dinner tonight. So just pat it. This is part two of our dinner, so don't forget to wash the first part. No, we're almost done. I'm just gonna take some garnish, some cute little vanilla wafers. I'm gonna place it real nice. And this is where the whipped cream come on play. You just put a little bit right there. That's it. You're all done. And this will be the best dessert you have for your family. So you guys try it out. Let me know how it comes out. All right, all done. It just came out perfectly. I want you guys to don't forget to like, subscribe, and share the video. If you do make it, just go ahead and put a picture down below. Let me know how it came out. Bye.